going to the electrical union. Current behold, a grade point average of 3.1, his favorite memory from wrestling was participating in the Buckeye tournament in Ohio. His funniest moment was going out to eat with his teammates at a Cracker Barrel, where they were enjoying each other's company and laughing too loud. He was thankful for his grandparents, coaches, and teammates. His greatest influence in his life are his parents. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a round of applause for Ian Lanning. Another round of applause for Ian, please. Our first contest tonight features your Mountain Pump Mustangs versus William Hill's Wolverines. Head coach for the Plum Wrestling is Mike Supek. He is accompanied by DJ Martin, John Marotti, and David Martin.
Oh, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Rick Barat. I'm here with my son, Zach Barat, and one of my childhood friends. You well aware who it is, has been doing our color commentating for the last several years, Steve Zuma. Steve, how are you tonight?
I'm fine. How are you?
Real good, real good. Little strange match tonight. I don't know if you'd call it a quad match. It was going to be a quad match as Plum's going to take on Woodland Hills tonight. They were going to wrestle Riverview, but Riverview had some injuries, COVID issues, and so here we are. We have Penn Trafford versus Gateway, which is going to be interesting to call, and we have Plum and Woodland Hills.
Yep, and Plum and Woodland Hills is starting right now. Looks like we got Jared Citrano out there. He gets the reverse. Well, he didn't bring him down yet. Now he gets the two for the reverse. He lets him up. I guess that'll be his plan to get some practice in here. Jared's doing pretty good. Not Jared, Vince.
Yeah, Vince.
Jared's his brother. There's another takedown by Vince, and he lets him up. There's another takedown. Vince is going to probably let him up back again. Up.
So we're looking at a 6-3 score here, Steve.
Yeah.
Woodland Hills doesn't have a lot of guys, a lot of wrestlers on their roster. They have a total of
Vince is going three. For the pin here. You got a tilt going. He's not going to get the pin that way, but he's get some points.
He'll get
he's
some
already
back
up
points.
9-4. And those four were just let up escapes. He's trying something here. A little underhook action. Shrug by. Gets two again. He's going for the tilt again. On the Oklahoma tilt, here we go, and he puts him on his back. Getting the back count here.
Yeah, he's
I don't
close
know if he's
there.
Looking for a pin
yeah.
or attack. He should be.
Well,
he cuts him loose again.
So 14-5.
Still
close to
a minute
a
and a half
ball,
left
yeah.
in this period. He takes him down again.
And I thought he was going to let him up there, Steve.
Ah, there's a cradle here.
Cradle.
And he pins him.
So sure.
That's a nice match by
Yeah, I mean, that was quick. I mean, 16-6, he got the pin. So Citrano gets the first victory. And now the last match, feels like we just started. But the last match for Plum tonight, who do we have here, Steve?
Looks like Paul McClintock to me, but.
Yeah, it does.
I'm not sure.
See the ref going over to coach.
Yeah, they're going to clarify this.
Yeah, it looks like, the ref went over to Coach Supek and asked him something. So.
Yeah, because this is a tangential slot here, but.
Yeah.
They're going to be wrestling Paul McClintock up.
Paul's a junior, correct?
Paul's a junior.
Zach, my son, used to play soccer with him.
There's a takedown by McClintock for two.
Right off the bat.
He's trying to throw a half in here. Digging. Trying to get it in.
He's trying to turn him there. He wasn't able to.
He got a cross wrist rod there. Trying to sneak his arm in, but he can't. They got a stall call here on the Woodland Hills guy. It's a warning. Another one of them, he'll get a point taken off him.
Minute left here in the first period. Paul 2-0 lead.
Paul looks like he's dominating this match here.
Trying to turn him again.
Got the tight waist, he's bringing the arm back. Looks like Paul just wants to ride him. There's no, don't see no way he can get a pin from anything he's trying. And I always try, so here we go, trying to tilt.
See, he was swaying.
He got the arm dug in now.
Yeah, I mean, why was he? Was he just looking at a better position as he's like swaying himself there back and forth?
He was just trying to get his arm out like he got now. But now he's trying to drive it. I don't think he's going to get it. We got 5 seconds left.
Yeah, he's definitely not going to get it, is he? And that's going to be the end of the first.
I'm guessing his opponent's Josh Granger. He got a choice here. They choose neutral. A little hand fighting. Oh.
Shot.
Graves goes in for a single.
Yeah, he got him. He's not doing anything with it, though.
Paulie's trying to whizzer him here. Oh, he gets two. Two for Woodland Hills. That ties the matchup. The Woodland Hills guy's using his weight advantage to his
big time
to his advantage here.
Now, what should Paul try to do?
He's going for the bow and arrow right now.
Yeah, he is. And Steve, what should Paul try to do here? Like, what should? I mean,
he needs to break the hands up right now. He needs to work on the hands, just so he can't. Once the kid locks up and rolls with it, then he's in trouble.
Now,
there he goes. Paulie's standing up. Now he's working on the hands. They go out of bounds. They're going to start. Paulie's going to be on bottom. Needs a quick move here. Top man gets cross wrist rod.
Yeah, I don't know if he can do anything here, Steve. I don't know if Paul's tired. He's trying to get up.
There, he's working on the hands.
Working on the hands to get
he's
out.
Working on it.
Trying to get
trying
that
to
point.
Trying to break the grip and get one at least. Looks like he's going to be successful. Oh, they're calling a stall on us. On Plum. Back down to the mat. Got 25 seconds left.
And here he got 10 seconds.
Woodland Hills slips legs in.
Oh.
Paulie trying to shake him.
Smart job here by the Woodland Hills wrestler, right, Steve? He took his forearm, drove his head into the mat a little bit, you know.
That's the end of the second period. We're going to the third. Looks like it's Paulie's choice. He chooses neutral.
Interesting.
Hmm.
Thought maybe he would.
I thought he might. I guess after that ride, he doesn't want to takedown and try to get
one.
Down
and try to get the one.
He's going to have to try to get the takedown here like he did in the first period, but he failed in the second. There Cage, Paulie gets the head wrap. There we go.
Oh, no, he lost it there.
Woodland Hills wrestler was a little too long for him.
Yeah. Well, that's exactly what it is. It's it might be a height thing here,
Steve. Paul's fighting. They go out.
And Paul's a little frustrated here. You can see, you know, Coach Supak typically doesn't have a lot to say, but, you know, he's Zach doesn't
There's
have
There's two by McClintock. Beautiful.
Mike's.
Take run.
I was going to say Mike's on the edge of his chair here. Little concern here with a minute 15 left Paul's here in the match.
Yeah. Even though he's already won it. There, Paulie goes for the pin.
Oh.
He's getting back points. He loses his hold, but he's... Now he's working his way back and getting the half in there. He got his three backs. Now he's got to work for the pin.
Oh.
Don't get too far. Keep his weight back.
Oh, now he's wearing on him. Oh, it's close.
Keep your weight back.
Oh, yeah, right there.
Now he's working on, he's a little too far off from his head there. Now, there we go. Now he's locked
in. Cinched in, yeah.
This could end, end soon, and it does. A win by Paulie McClintock.
Yeah, good match
Looked like
by Paulie.
Looked like he was wrestling up, too. He definitely had to be. He was visibly smaller than his opponent.
No, without a doubt.
And I think that was all the matches we're going to see in this match.
Yeah, I think
Plum gets two pins, and then we're going to get a lot of forfeits.
Yeah, so now, I see we have some junior high wrestlers here, Steve. They'll eventually come out onto the, not matches. You can see Coach Supak here with the disinfectant. He'll come across here in the camera view in a second, but they're going to wipe down the mats for the Gateway Penn Trafford match. So.
All right.
So here comes Coach Supak right now.
Look at Supak. Spray it, baby. Take that COVID out of there.
Yes. So you can see the junior high wrestlers are following him up here so they can clean up the match.
This is actually a good idea.
Well, absolutely. And, Steve, like you and I talked before the match, we might see this between matches in the future,
it should happen.
You know, like we've seen in soccer when it's really hot, and Zach will tell you, they've had water breaks where they'll stop it if it's like 90 degrees. They'll stop it at the 20-minute mark at a 40-minute half just to give everyone a breather, you know, because there's been deaths with heat exhaustion and stuff. You might see something like this, you know, after match six or, you know, match five, where they disinfect the matches. This could be something we see for the rest of our lives here.
This is actually a good idea too, though. I mean, it's
sure. And we can see it looks like I see a big mop there, and it's a little bit off to the left. I think that's the dry mop.
The big one.
Yes.
That's like 4 foot long.
Yeah, I think it's Coach Supak. I think they're all kind of dry mops, but I think it's Coach Supak kind of dries the sprays that disinfectant. You know, and then the junior
the one spread it around.
Yeah, they spread it around, and then the big one,
the big
one cleans it up, so it dries it off type of deal, you know? So we'll see what, you know, it looks like they're almost done. I mean, Coach Supak's done spraying.
Definitely more than halfway. Watch the big mop.
Yeah.
What's our next match going to be? It looks like it's Penn Trafford and Gateway.
Yeah, and actually Plum and Woodland Hills have honestly vacated. Plum is up on the stands on the left side here of the screen. They're out of the stands. Penn Trafford's off to the right. Zach's zooming out right now. Plum's up in the stands. Woodland Hills is up in the stands with their small roster. And then you have... you know, you got Trafford on the right and Gateway on the left. And we're only going to have, Gateway only has five wrestlers. So we're only going to see five more matches, you know. Which I'm interested to watch Trafford here. Now I know Gateway's not a, not a
powerhouse.
Not a power. Yeah, exactly. For lack of a better word, they're not a powerhouse. But Penn Trafford has been.
Oh yeah.
So I'm kind of looking forward to this, Steve, because it's been years since we've called a Trafford match, because they're typically in another section.
Yeah.
So kind of looking forward to this here.
It looks like they have a pretty good team too.
Well, they have a full roster,
a full
obviously.
Full roster, and they have backups at almost every weight.
Yes.
So, wrestling hasn't affected. COVID hasn't affected their wrestling team at all. And it looks like Penn Trafford won the flip. They're happy about that.
Yeah, they're real happy about that. He raised his hand.
Worried about this
victory
match.
There.
They've already won this match on forfeits to begin with.
Sure. So who do we have here, Steve? I mean, I don't know any of these guys. You have the roster.
I think we're going to start at 106. I think he's going to get a bye. Even Harper.
Okay. So they'll send out the wrestler. He'll get the win.
They're going to start at 106, and it looks like they're going to get a bye. But they're Penn Trafford's 112 at Trey Homan. He's actually undefeated for the season. And he looks like he's going to have a match. I'm not sure if they're going to avoid him or not. And looks like they might. 116? 113. Wait, maybe this is home in here. I've been told they're starting at 113. Homan's going right after the pin. He gets the takedown real quick.
He's fast too, Steve. I mean, he went right. He attacked. And we've seen that with palm wrestlers before.
Yeah, this boy, he's been good for a long time. I remember him. He lets him up. He's going to go for the takedown again. But
notice when he let him up, though. He didn't even give him any space, Steve. He let him up.
He was going for the cradle, another takedown. I'm not sure what he's going to do here, if he's going to just keep playing with him or just pin him. And it looks like he's going up. Yep, he's going for a cradle, near side cradle. Gateway fights it off, so he's just going to let him up.
We'll give him the point there.
Yep. Go around for Homan. Another let up.
Minute in the first period. 6-3. Trafford.
Homan does another spin around for two.
Two more.
Another.
It's 8-3.
Up. There we go.
Uh-oh.
Tilting him for a couple back points here. It looks like he's holding two. And he lets go of the hold, so he just gets two back points, and then lets him up.
Now we'll have 10-4 here, Steve. Technical fall is how many, just for any of the viewers?
15 is a technical fall.
So as soon as you're up by 15, that's it.
He'll probably just mess with him for a little bit and then go for the pin before he gets 15, because you get one less point.
Yes.
Not that that really matters in this, but
sure.
To him it probably does.
We have 10 seconds left here in the first, and he's out.
15 to 4 score here. We got 10. Yeah, it's about 10 seconds left. Okay, we start down. And sets up. Pulls the arm in here. Another tilt. He rolls through it.
Yeah, he wasn't able to pin him in the first.
Okay, there we go. We're going to the second period. What's the score? 14 to.
I don't know. 14-5. He didn't give him any points there from the last 11.4 seconds. So.
Yeah, 9-point lead here. The helmet takes down.
And you assume he'll pop up here. You assume, Steve, he'll pop up real quick.
On his wrist here. Looks like he's trying to Peterson him up. Gets a stand up here. He's working on the hands. Trying to break the grip.
Oh. Try to go around and working on his back.
Working on the hands, he's trying to get the one here. Gateway's fighting him.
Yeah, he's doing well.
I like that. Up.
Oh.
There's a Gramby from stand-up position. Nice. Oh, shrug by Bowman for two. And he's going, looks like he might be going for the pin here, but he's, I don't think he's going to get a pin with this move. It's another tilt. That's.
So it's 17-5. We'll give him two.
He's got a major decision right
now.
But
what do you call here?
Oh,
that's it. Is that a technical fall?
That was a tech fall, yeah.
Yeah, because it's 17-5. He gave him three for back point to go up.
Yeah, he was
25.
Yeah.
22-5.
Hey, kudos to the Gateway kid for not letting himself get pinned.
No, absolutely. Yeah. 138, Steve, for Trafford. 138. Yeah, I don't have my reading glasses. Zach.
I know, I'm having a hard time reading.
Can you read the lineups? We don't have our reading glasses. That's how old your dad and Steve Zuma is. 138. And before we can even read the names, it's a pin.
Oh, we got a pinfall already.
Here, Zach, put on the headset and call out the names since your eyes are better than ours.
Looks like we're going to. Ott.
We have Owen Ott here.
Owen Ott for Penn Trafford. Lloyd McKenna for Gateway.
Yeah, McKenna. That's what he just said, Steve. McKenna
Ott
seems
is 11-8.
McKenna seems to be in shape here. He's a little bit bigger than Ott.
Yeah.
I mean, that doesn't mean much. We'll see how they wrestle here.
Ott, I remember his name too. So he's been wrestling for a while. Pretty aggressive match here already.
Yeah, he.
I like that. Two are going after each other.
The Gateway wrestler just looks physical.
Gateway wrestler is only a sophomore. So is Ott. They're both sophomores. Oh, he gets the shrug by for two. Ott does. Trying to work a leg in. And he does.
Now what's Ott trying to do here? Is he just trying to turn him here, Steve?
That's his eventual goal. But it looks like he's up.
Wow, and he has his arm hooked too, right?
Yeah. He's just riding legs and just just turning them. You don't see too many leg wrestlers out there. It works. I've seen a lot of people doing it. When you do it good, it's kind of hard to stop.
Good bridge.
Oh, there he goes.
Good bridge there by the Gateway wrestler.
Going for the guillotine here. He wants to flip this over his head. He's trying to. And he gets it.
Wow.
Now Gateway could be
5 seconds
here.
Left, though.
Can he get the pin within 5 seconds? I don't. Wow. Gateway's fighting pretty good.
Wow.
Nice match. McKenna's pretty tough here.
Yeah, he did a good job with the legs.
I threw those legs in. He threw that guillotine in. He just
Trafford up here.
Got his backs for that.
Yeah, Trafford up 5-0.
Eight nothing.
Yes,
and after one, but it's closer. It's definitely closer than that.
And they both start off in the neutral position, Steve. So the wrestlers didn't want to go down or up.
No.
So
McKenna going for the single, and he's going for a headlock. He's trying to pull it off, and.
Now would the
illegal hold there by Gateway. He didn't have an arm on that head. You have to have an arm in there or they're going to call you for an illegal hold. Well, hand fighting. Getting a little chippy with each other. Kind of ties up tight. Looks like Ah wants to be a little bit further out. They don't want to be tying up like that. Shot by McKenna. Ah fights it. He's going. McKenna going for the headlock again. Couldn't get it. Ah body. He brings him straight to his back.
Oh, yeah. And Ah has him in good position here, Steve.
Ah needs to tie that arm up a little harder here and get the head in there.
See if he can turn him. He's starting to turn him. Now he's on his.
We got three for Ah. He's got a 14-0 here. We got 42 seconds left.
Well, he's going to get worst-case scenario. Steve, he'll get a tech fall here and go up, you know. It's 14-1, so 15 is that tech fall. So,
Gateway starts down. McKenna's down. Ah's going to get on top here.
Wonder if he'll just let him up, Steve. Now he's trying to
slip his legs in there.
Good bridge.
Crossbody riding. Now he's gonna try that guillotine again, trying to get it over his head.
Try to turn
this
him.
This will end the match for him. If he gets back points.
He's just cranking
and
that left shoulder.
He ties it in there. We've seen this in the first period.
Yeah, he got him, Steve.
He's looking for the pin here.
5 seconds left, though.
Got it. And he's ties up. Nope.
Oh.
And three backs. That
Give
will
three,
end.
And that will be it.
That will end the match.
Yeah,
McKenna fought that off, and he needed a little more time. But
McKenna
Ah
did well, though.
With the tech ball. Yeah, that was a good fight by Gateway again.
So now we're getting into a little bit of the bigger boys now, Steve.
152, this is Lucas Pazak. I believe. David Clark for Gateway. Pazak goes for the cement mixer right off the bat.
Yeah.
Standing up. That takes some strength to try to do that. Tie up. Pazak gets head under. Looks like he's trying to dump him again.
Yeah.
Nope.
Let him go. What's the Gateway wrestler trying to do, Steve, when he locks his left hand up on his shoulder there? Is he trying to shoot him? Try to go in and grab that other leg?
Yeah, he wants to go cross leg if he can. There's double leg by Pazak with the takedown. Got a Navy ride on him right now.
Yeah.
In between his legs. He's trying to, wants to keep that if he can. And he lets it go. He could have used that to turn if he wanted.
Yeah, why didn't he do that, Steve? Why did he go up and grab him around the chest? You'd think he'd want to keep that.
He definitely would want to keep that. That's actually a hard position to get into to try. But Pazak going for a single. Oh, he's holding a single leg right
now.
I think he has two already. Clark's trying to escape. Got 20 seconds left. Stands up with it. Pazak trying to trip him. Nope. They go out.
Wow.
10 seconds left for 9.
Still 2-0. 2-0. Gateway wrestler Steve chooses down. Try to pop up here and try to get that escape point here in 9 seconds.
Pazak trying to hold him for the last couple seconds here.
Close.
He almost got the one, but he didn't.
Yeah, I thought he got
caught that leg at the last second.
Yeah.
He let that go. He would have gave up one with a couple seconds. Gateway has a choice, and they choose down.
I'm okay with that because he should have got the point last time. I think he feels he can get up.
He feels pretty positive there at that point.
You know, if he can get up and get that point, get the escape, it's 2-1.
Mazak throws a wicked crossface there from the riding position.
Uh-oh. Oh, I let him go.
Uh-oh. We could see a switch here. We do.
Oh.
Reversal.
It is a reversal.
By Clark.
Trying to turn
Clark's
him.
Clark's trying to put him over. He wants to hold the wrist, and he's driving it. He has the wrist in the
half,
and he didn't get the back points. But he ties the matchup with that reversal, which was nice. Mazak stands up. Back down. Clark brings him back down to the mat. For some reason, he's going for the forearm. Well, he was. We got, 30 seconds left in the period
30 seconds.
Here.
Good match.
Still working on that. There he goes. Now he's trying to drive that forearm through. Now it's his near arm. He wants to walk around his head with that. Mazak is fighting it with his hips on the opposite. So he keeps
driving
his doing exactly what you should be doing. Every time he switches sides, you switch.
Uh-oh.
Mazak escapes with
10 seconds
left.
Yeah.
He gets the 3-2 advantage. They're going to go to the third. It don't look like anyone's going to shoot here.
Well, this sets up Steve.
It's
going to
be
Zach.
His choice.
Yeah, this sets up to be a pretty good third period here.
Yeah.
We haven't seen it all night. This sets up to be very interesting here.
Hey, Zach chooses down. It was his choice. He chooses down, so.
He got up.
He's looking for the escape. He doesn't get it. They got a lot of bonds. They're going to have a restart here. He wants to get the escape and then the takedown if he can. There. Trying again to stand up. Clark's trying to bring him back to the mat. He has no luck doing that. There you go, out of bounds.
Yeah, out of bounds. So still 3-2 here. Minute 37 left to go in the third.
It's looking like a good match.
Yeah, real good match here. You know, both teams will start, you know, cheering on their respective wrestlers here as we get under a minute. It gets time for the nitty gritty.
Ben Trafford chose underneath, and so far he hasn't been able to escape. Gateway boy is doing pretty good on top.
Now, how's he going to try to get points here, Steve?
He needs to put him on his back.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Illegal hold.
Legal hold.
So Mazak gets one anyway. So Clark's going to have to put him on his back.
Yeah, he's going to have to.
He got a minute 16 left here. Out of that.
Oh, he almost had him there, Steve. Under a minute, 50 seconds.
Clark going for the cradle. He lets that go.
Has to be
looks
a
like
little
Mazak
bit
content with got, being underneath there.
Got to be aggressive here, Steve. He has under 40 seconds. I think he just took
there's
a peek
nothing,
at the clock.
Nothing really happening. They're just,
he's looking at the clock, so
yeah,
he knows he's under 25 seconds. Smart move by the Penn Trafford wrestler. Should he just try to climb out?
Yeah, he doesn't look like he's trying to escape or anything.
No,
just,
he's
happy
fine
with his 4-2
yeah
win. There, going out in front here. He's going to try to mix them up. Get the last seconds here, but it's going to be not enough.
And he gets,
gets the escape.
Yeah, he gets the escape,
but
gets 1 point.
He had to try to put him on his back, and that's what he had to do.
So we have the last match of the evening here, Steve. Heavyweights. This is what we like. The bigger guys. We've seen some big heavyweight matches in our days here at Plum. We have.
Who is this?
What is it?
I don't even know.
285?
Yeah, probably.
That's Joe Emick.
Joe Emick.
So far, both wrestlers just kind of feeling each other out.
This is the typical heavyweight match.
Who's going to grab who? Who's going to? Now, when you had, we've had, when McCarthy and Brian Cartwright, those guys were, for their size, had some decent speed.
Oh, yeah.
They could shoot.
Yeah, like Di Leonardo.
Di Leonardo. See, I was just trying to think. Yeah, they could shoot. Yeah.
They were good heavyweights.
Yes. 2-0 here, Gateway wrestler.
Gateway gets the takedown here.
Yeah.
To Gavin Reed. Reed doesn't look like he's having that bad of a season. Looks like he's 3-2.
And he has some good size, Steve. We saw it also with the Woodland Hills, the one wrestler. You have some height. It's harder for those shorter wrestlers to get their, hands and mitts around
speak. They have to fight their battles. They can't fight the tall guys' battles. You give in to what they want to do, then you're in trouble.
10 seconds left here in the first period. It could be in for another good match here.
All right, looks like the first period's going to end. We're going to the second. Not sure whose choice this is.
I think the
Gateway's.
Yeah, Gateway's, and I think he's choosing down.
And he's taking down. I think the ref's going to make him spin around.
Yeah, he did make him spin around. That's a lot of energy, for the heavyweight.
And Trevor on top here. So far, they're losing 2-0, so. Like Reed's going for the escape. Oh, Petraver gets the leg. Back to the mat they go. Petraver cross facing him to no avail. Gateway kids trying. There he goes. Does a stand up. Hand control. Up. Oh. And Trapper throws the near side crane one. Can he turn him with that? He's looking for it. Oh my God! Very good.
Wow.
He has it. That might be.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh wow.
Reed escapes that. Breaks the grip off his head. But after he gives up three on the back.
Yes, 3-2.
Which puts Penn Trapper ahead.
Got to make that.
5 seconds left here.
Makes that bridge, so he's going to try to stand up here. He has 35 seconds. Oh, he's
break
up.
Go over to stand up, and then you got.
Just has to break.
Got Trapper going for the near side cradle. Ooh. Again. Deja vu all over again. And I don't think he has what he wants. He might defensively pin himself.
Yeah, he was on the bottom there.
Now there's
wow,
a reversal,
yeah.
And he is in trouble now. Gateway Reed is on top, and there he gets
the pin.
Wow,
that was a good one.
What a reversal of fortune when that was. Nice match by the Gateway boy, Reed.
And he's exhausted, too. He's gasping for air, yeah.
That was everything he had.
Yeah, no doubt, no doubt. So
I think that was going to be the last
Yeah, that
match.
Was it. Unfortunately, that's all we have for wrestling. That's one. That's the one.
That's it.
Yeah.
No matches.
Yeah, well, that's the only home one.
Unless they're going to do it without tape.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll have to. I mean, I know that Mr. Shoup, our athletic director, is looking for matches and stuff, Steve. But, yeah, the wrestlers are cleaning up, you know. Plum beats, you know, defeats Woodland Hills. You know, there's only two matches. Obviously, Trafford with a 25-6 victory over Gateway tonight. You know, but, you know, it was
probably more than that with all the forfeits.
Yeah, oh, yeah, 100%.
Yeah,
but
I don't think the scoreboard added them up.
But, yeah, that's all we have here. Steve, anything to add? You know, we'll let you know if we have another one. You know, everything's up in the air with, you know, COVID year. But
hopefully Plum's had a good year so far.
Yeah. They've,
and they have some good – and they're a young team.
Yes.
As long as they all stick with it, we're going to be a nice team here in the future.
Yes.
And we're a nice team actually right now.
No, they are a nice team right now. So, yeah, no doubt.
As long as they can keep this up, things are looking good for Plum Wrestling.
Yes.
And
well,
hopefully the COVID thing goes away and
yes,
they can go back to normal.
No doubt. No doubt.
Because I know that this definitely had to hurt them this year.
Yes. Well, that's all we have here. Steve, thanks. It's always been a pleasure.
No problem.
Yeah.
I love it.
Zach, very good tonight on the camera, even though you didn't do a lot over there. But, yeah, that's all we have here. So we hope everyone is staying safe, and have a good night, everybody.
Good night.